What's up, guys? Lewin here at GarageBand and beyond. Today, we're taking a look at the coolest guitar tuner I've ever seen in my life. This is the ROADIE 2. It's a very, very cool little tuner. It retails at $120, but I don't want you to think that that's a lot of money for a guitar tuner because it's not just a guitar tuner. Obviously, as you saw in that video before, it does turn the knobs for you. But as I'm going to tell you, it does a lot more than that. So let's jump right into what I think is really the thing that makes this so much more than just a guitar tuner, okay? That is the application that it comes with. Now, I should add, you can run this tuner without the app, not like the old one. It has a little onboard screen here, and you can, it's got a wheel that you can turn here to go through your menus and whatnot, button to push it on and off. But you can use it independent of the app. However, that app is what gives this thing all of the cool features. So let's look at the app. All right, so the ROADIE 2, just like the old one, they had this app, but it is nice that you don't have to use it all the time when you want to just use the tuner. So let's just go into it. So the first thing you see when you open up the app is the tutorial section. There are tutorials galore on their website, which there is also a link for down below. It's a nice thing. The first thing you see is here's how to use your toy and here's all the stuff it can do. Very, very nice. Next down the list is instruments. These are the things that I have sort of set up as I've had this for about a week now. My different instruments that I have here in the house. One thing you should notice is the Martin capo 2. Yes, you can tune with a capo on, which I think is totally amazing. Here's a video of me doing it myself. The guitar, my Martin HD28 actually does have a slight intonation issue that I have not had fixed yet. So the higher up I go on the neck, the more often I find, the strings are going sharp. And one of my capo's settings is on the 7th fret, in which case, it's fine. The guitar by itself is fine. But if I'm playing with my band, everybody else is like, what is going on, So I used to have to put the capo on and then tune, which was a total, if you've done it before, it's a pain in the ass to, go back and forth with the capo on the strings. It makes it so much more difficult. It's as easy with or without the capo. It tunes it just as quickly, which is very quickly. So that is one of my favorite features because I use a capo a lot and that'll make it a lot easier for me to, make sure that I'm in tune with my band. And I will be using this on stage. It's cool. As I've gotten older, I should say this, I've gotten a lot older. I'm in my 40s and I have issues with my finger here. I have some arthritis. And when I reach over to turn my tuners, my fingers hurt. Any older player will tell you one of the things that hurts them the most is simply turning the tuning gears because it hurts your hands to do that. So that's why I like this thing. It's going to save my hand pain out the window. It's going to throw it out the window. Thank God. So we're going to keep going down. I don't know if you can hear, but somebody's using a vacuum behind me. Wonderful. Syncing, when you do make your own customized, instrument settings on the app, you just hit the sync button and then it sends everything over to the unit itself. Pretty easy. Tunings, you can see what these are. All sorts of different tunings that are available. And let's just look at guitar here. Okay, so 6 strings. Okay, so look at this. Look at this list of tunings that's available. One of the things, as a guitar player out there, I'm sure you're aware of all of these tunings or maybe half of them, whatever. You're aware of all these alternate tunings that are available to you. But I would be willing to bet that you don't use them that often. And one of the reasons may be that you don't know exactly what every single string should be tuned to, or you just, you don't feel like dealing with it. You're like, oh, it's such a pain in the butt to tune and up and the whole process. This combination of this and the, being able to have it automatically do it for you. I'll tell you right now, I've had so much fun over the week playing with these alternate tunings on my own guitars, just because it's so much easier to get there now. I don't have to remember exactly what is every interval there. This does all the work for me there. And then it just does it. You know what I mean? So it opens up alternate tunings to you in a much more friendly way because you don't have to do any of the quote unquote heavy lifting, the app and the tuner do it all for you. Next thing is just basic setting stuff, nothing too exciting here. Like I said before, tuning with a capo on, super cool. The app is fabulous. It really works very well. The only thing, and guys at Roadie, if you watch this, I noticed that when I was trying to put in a name for the customized instruments, it wasn't really too happy about me trying to find the keyboard. I had to what I ended up doing was sort of tapping all over the screen, and eventually the keyboard popped up. But you guys might want to take a look at that. It's a brand new app. I think it's only been out for about a month. So obviously we can be expecting updates to the app. One thing I should talk about here is the strength of the motor in this tuner. I was wondering, you know, how strong is it? I have a 1967 Gibson with really stiff old tuners. This had absolutely no problem turning the tuners on that old Gibson, which I thought was totally awesome. I will add that as the battery got down to somewhere around, you know, 25% left, it wasn't tuning as quickly, wasn't finding the notes as quickly, and it did slowly start to struggle to turn my tuners. So whatever, I just charged it again. It was a pretty quick thing to charge. I think it took me about an hour and a half to charge it, and you know, it's so far that's lasted over a week. So here, let's pretend like we're just going to add a new instrument just so you can see how this whole thing goes down. So acoustic guitar, yes. Six strings, yes. We're just going to say it's an Epiphone. So here's where I'm going to call it. Test, call it test one because I already have one in there. I could add a photo, which is really nice. You know, headstock, whatever you want. I'm not going to do that now, but yes, you could do it. And so here, test one. So we go here. Here I can tell it, you know, whatever tuning I want this to be. I could make it, you know, a dedicated alternate tuning or whatnot. I can also change the capo settings, which I love, obviously. I can also change what it considers A. It starts at, let's go all the way down to the bottom, 420 and all the way up to 460. So that gives you a pretty wide berth to work with. You know, for people out there who work with piano players that don't have pianos that are imperfectly in tune, this would be a fabulous thing because you could put, you know, a custom setting into the tuner and say, Dave's piano. And then every time you're playing with Dave's piano, you put this on your guitar and your guitar is in tune with Dave's out of tune piano. Whoever David may be, he needs to tune his piano. But if he hasn't yet, this is how you can work around it. But anyway, A440, super easy. And anyway, that's about it. All right. So it's a super, super cool tuner. I absolutely love it. I highly, highly recommend it to people who are getting older with hand pain. People who have tons of instruments. If you're a guitar roadie, I mean, come on, you can use this in a noisy environment. Every guitar tech in the world should have one of these things, if you ask me. Any guitar gadget guy needs one, and pretty much everybody should buy one. No. Anyway, that's not really what I'm saying. Well, yeah, sure. Everybody should buy one. They're awesome. I love it. If you guys play guitar and you like gadget stuff, this is right up your alley. I highly recommend it. That's all I think I should say. So if you have any questions, please leave it in the comment section below. And of course, watch all the other videos here on GarageBand and beyond. There are so many videos. I've been doing it for a long time. And if you'd like to help support my channel grow and survive, please check out my Patreon page because that is exactly how I am surviving. So, all right, you guys, I hope you enjoy the videos. I hope you have a great weekend and I'll talk to you soon. All right, peace.